Hello students, good morning all. Today we are going to recap the chapter The Best Christmas in the World. Let's first revise with word with their meaning. Bridport, a market town in Dorset, England, situated approximately 1.5 miles inland from British Channel. Junk shop, a shop selling miscellaneous second-hand or old out-of-use materials. Roll top desk, a desk with a flexible sliding cover. Spotted it, found it, scratch marks, burn marks, clumsily mended. Without skill, repaired. Veneer, a thin layer of plastic or decorative wood on furniture of cheap wood. Brute force, violent force. Tommy, used to refer a common soldier in British Army. Fritz, popular German nickname. No man's land, a piece of land which falls in the middle of the borders of two countries. Parapet, a low protective wall at the edge of the trench. Marzipan, a sweet covering on a cake made from sugar, eggs and almonds. Thomas Hardy, famous English novelist. Far from the Madding Crowd, fourth novel of Thomas Hardy. Bathsheba, Bathsheba, a virgin, beautiful young heroine of Far from the Madding Crowd. Gabriel Oak, a former shepherd. Gabriel Oak is the hero of Far from the Madding Crowd. Surgeon Troy, Surgeon Francis Troy, the villain of Far from the Madding Crowd. Conservatory, a room having glass roof and walls typically attached to a house on only one side. Wicker chair, a chair made of wicker and is thus ventilated and useful under not or humid condition. We have seen 20 meanings, isn't it? While reading, it becomes easy. One more time if you read, it comes more easy. Isn't it? Like that, please read until and unless you get the confidence, you don't jump into the next roman or next work. Please do reading and after that, write and see. The important task for the students now is to write and see. Write and see, then only you will get the correct spellings. For example, here there are 20 meanings, isn't it? You can take either 5 at a time, learn and write and see and correct by yourself. Self-assessment is the best assessment in the world. Please check, read, write. Again, make a retest if it is necessary. After learning these 20 meanings, then go to question answers. What did the author find in a junk shop? The author found a 19th century roll top desk in the junk shop. Who do you think had put the letter in there? Mrs. Jim MacPherson, who was Jim's wife, might put the letter in. Who had written the letter to whom and when? Jim MacPherson had written the letter to his wife, Connie MacPherson, on December 26, 1914. You can change the answers without changing the meaning. And with the correct spelling and with the correct grammatical structure, you can frame the sentences on your own. Why was the letter written What was the wonderful thing that had happened? Jim wrote a letter to tell his wife about a wonderful thing that had happened on Christmas Day. The British and the Germans were engaged in war, yet on this day, both the troops met in no man's land. It was a thing of wonder because right in the middle of a war, the warring soldiers were making peace. What a job did Hans, Ulf and Jim MacPherson have when they were not soldiers? Hans Ulf played the cello in the orchestra when he was not a soldier. Jim MacPherson was a teacher in Dorset when not a soldier. Had Hans Ulf ever been to Dorset? No, Hans Ulf had never been to Dorset. Why did the author go to Bridport? The author went to Bridport because that was the address where Mrs. MacPherson lived. The address on the letter read Mrs. Jim MacPherson, 12 Copper, Beaches, Bridport, and Dorset. He wanted to give that letter back to her. How old was Mrs. MacPherson now? Where was she? Mrs. MacPherson was 101 years old. She was in a nursing home in Burlington House on the Dorchester Road on the other side of town. Who did Connie MacPherson think her visitor was? Connie MacPherson thought that her visitor was her husband Jim. Which sentence in the text shows that the visitor did not try to hide his identity? The sentence which shows that the visitor did not try to hide his identity is, I explained about the desk, about how I had found it, but I don't think she was listening. There are totally 10 short question answers here. Again, you can have your own choices, like you can go with the 2 sentences or 4 question answers at a time. Please read and write it once and see how far is your understanding. Please check out the spellings, everything, okay? Then we can go with the another set of question answers now. For how long do you think Connie had kept Jim's letter? Give reason for your answer. Connie must have kept Jim's letter for a long time. This is because she told the narrator how she read it quite often every day so that she could feel that Jim was near her. Why do you think the desk had been sold and when? The desk must have been sold when the house in which Connie MacPherson lived had caught fire. She was taken to a nursing home. All the burnt up things must have been sold after that. Why do Jim and Hans think that games or sports are good ways of resolving conflicts? Do you agree? Jim and Hans thought that games or sports are good ways of resolving conflicts because nobody dies in matches, no children are orphaned, and no wives become widows. Due to these reasons, games are good ways for resolving conflicts. Wars only lead to death and devastation. Do you think the soldiers of the two armies are like each other or different from each other? Find evidence from the story to support your answer. The soldiers of the two armies were like each other. Below are some instances from the story to prove. Both the armies celebrated Christmas. Both the armies shared their food and spent time together in smoking, laughing, talking, drinking, and eating. They played a football match and agreed that conflicts and disputes may be resolved by football match. They agreed about the negative aspects of war and longed peace. They exchanged carols and hoped to unite with the families again. Mention the various ways in which the British and the German soldiers become friends and find things in common at Christmas. The British and the German troops celebrated Christmas with each other. They enjoyed each other's food. All of them were smoking, laughing, talking, drinking and eating. Hans Ulf and Jim McPherson shared the cake Connie had baked. They talked about Bathsheba, Gabriel Oak, Sergeant Troy and Dorset. They even talked about the books they liked. They agreed about everything. Both the troops played a game of football for which both Hans and Jim cheered, clapped hands and stamped feet. They also exchanged carols at night. In this way, they celebrated Christmas together, finding a lot in common between them. What is Connie's Christmas present? Why is it the best Christmas present in the world? When the narrator came to see Connie and gave her the book, she mistook him for her husband Jim. She thought that Jim had come home for Christmas. This was Connie's Christmas present. It was the best Christmas present in the world for her because Jim had written in the letter that he would come home on Christmas. She had read that letter several times every day to feel that he was near her. Now that he was finally there with her, she was extremely happy. Do you think the title of this story is suitable for it? Can you think of any other titles? Yes, the title of the story is suitable for it. The spirit of Christmas is the theme that prevails throughout the story. The message of Christmas peace and goodwill to all is brought out so clearly through the story. It was on a Christmas day in the middle of a raging war that two warring troops made peace. The moment of peace that the soldiers shared with each other was the best Christmas present for them. Again, it was on a Christmas day that the narrator went to see Mrs. McPherson. He went to return her husband's letter to her. The letter was precious to her, but even more precious was her delusion that the narrator was her husband Jim, who she believed had returned as promised on a Christmas day. This was the best Christmas present in the world for her. Suitable titles could be A Christmas Wish Comes True, Someday at Christmas, The Christmas Message, etc. You can choose your own justifying answer for this. This is my idea about it. Now, let me read a short summary for this. You can always add the titles like introduction and side headings and end with a conclusion. I'm just reading the gist of the short summary. The best Christmas present in the world is a touching story by Michael Morpurgo. The narrator buys an old desk and finds in it a letter written by an English soldier, Jim McPherson. It should be M-A, okay? To his wife Connie, whom the narrator goes to meet and hand over the letter. The letter was a touchy account of how the English soldiers and German soldiers wished each other happy Christmas, celebrated the festival with real Christmas spirit. There was no place for conflict, hatred and violence. The letter was written on 26th December 1914 and Jim wrote in his letter that he would be back by the next Christmas, as the incident between the two armies showed how soldiers from both sides wanted peace. The narrator could not sleep the whole night. It was Christmas Eve, as he had intruded in someone's privacy by reading the letter. In the morning, he went to the address mentioned in the letter, finds the house in shatters due to fire. Asked a neighbor and reached where Connie was. Connie was 101 years old, and she mistook the narrator as Jim and talked about her happiness on Jim's arrival. It was the best Christmas present for her in the world. Hope you have understood this session. It's just a recap about the chapter, The Best Christmas in the World. Okay. Please do writing practice more. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.